Next on the list, Fantrig 99. How many people I'm gonna review with nines in it? Light and darkness. Is that part of the nine? Okay, whatever. Anyways, oh, okay. 125 platinums. And got some games completed. And the completion rate's not bad. If you at least get at least 3, just 3% higher, maybe this list could have been a very, oh, sorry, maybe you could have been a very, very good score, but oh well. But what you've been playing recently? Dragon Quest 11, that's the platinum, looking like Zelda right there. And then Dragon Quest, that looks bad. That'd be looking like The Last of Us Platinum. What else? Dragon Quest, Dragon Quest, Dragon Quest. Just straight up Dragon Quest. That's all you've been playing. Alright. Well, let's get this list started. So straight off the bat, we got a nice collection of platinums over here. King's Tale, we got Adventures of Mana, Alpha Protocol, the Assassin's Creed's okay. But I don't know what's going on with these DLCs you're not doing, but I guess you gotta do those. Got the L tier games, okay. Batman games, oh my god, finally someone with Batman is actually completed. Now he's only missing Knights. Looks like he's missing Knight on this, or this looks like straight up PS3s. Is this PS4, right? He's probably taking his time on this, but DLCs, the Battlefields, DLCs, Bayonetta, DLC, but you got Bayonetta, so that's good. Bioshock 1, 2, and Infinite, that's great. DLC, the Borderlands, no DLC on that. But for some reason, you want to play the pre-sequel so damn bad that you do the DLC. What? I don't understand this. Like, what do you do? Complete a game, move forward to the next game. Oh, DLC out. You want to buy it? Or you just having, you don't want to play it. I don't know what's going on with this. Burly Man C, okay. Catherine, okay. Dark Souls, Demon Souls, not bad. But Darksiders 3 though, DLC. Detroit Become Human, DLCX, DLC. Okay, so you got the Devil May Cry, Diablo 3, nice. Dissidia's, oof. Man, that's a lot of work to do right there. I didn't even know Dissidia 2 had DLC. That was just, what the hell? But okay, Dishonored, that's great. DLC, second one, and then whatever else that came out, I can't remember. You got Dissidia Final Fantasy? I think you're the first one with that, as far as I know. That's great, nice. You got the Devil May Cry reboot, but no DLC. Oh my god. Okay, Dragon's Dogma. Looks like you haven't finished that. Maybe you should work on that soon. Fallen Region, okay, good. Man, this guy has Far Cry 2. W, dog. Final Fantasies. Wow. That is impressive right here. Look at that. Wow. From 9, Type O, 7, 10, 11. No, sorry, not 11. 12, 13, 14, 15. Man, if you would have gotten 14, this would have been amazing list. 14 and 15, this would have been amazing. Really amazing, especially 14, which takes a lot of fucking time. But this is really good. God Eater, okay. God of Wars. Ooh, this is kind of weird to see this right now. 3, Ascension, Chain of Abyss, and Sparta. What's going on? You don't even play 1 and 2? What happened here? Okay, alright. But anyways, Grand Kingdom. Nice. I don't think anyone else even had this platinum. That's good. Got that. You get GTA 5 with no DLC, but in GTA 4, you just didn't want to play it. What happened with that, man? But Heavy Rain, good. Hitman, Ico, Infamous 1 and 2, and that's it. The fuck? Only Just Cause 2, and then we got the Kingdom Hearts collection right here, so that's really nice to see here. I think you're probably just missing 3 and a couple other stackables, I think. LA Noire DLC, Max Payne 3, that's nice, you got the platinum, but the DLC is not. So get that done. Metal Gear Rising, same as that. Nice, you got the platinum, but no DLC, man. Like, you anti-DLC or something? Like, is Borderlands, like, the greatest game of all time that you gotta play the DLC for while everything else is crap to you? Like, what is this? Like, Metal Gear Solid is great. Mirror's Edge. Like, you even do Mirror's Edge DLC. What? Come on. Nier, Ninja Gaiden. Pretty sure you spend time touring with Rachel, but you ain't gonna get the DLC. Jeez, man. You got Neo with no DLC. Papers, please. DLC. Persona 4 Golden, nice. Got Persona 4. Oh, you're almost done with that. See, I'm surprised you have Ultimax, but not the other one. But okay, DLC, please. Persona 5, though, that's good. PlayStation also. Oh my god. What? Come on, man. Are you not spending money? You don't want to spend money on DLC? Is that what it is? Is it because pre-sequel gives you like the free? I don't know if you have to pay for DLC for that or you have to spend money on it, but what the hell, man? Okay, but look, you got Prototype, so okay, you know what? Forget the DLC. You got Prototype done. That's good. That's great. But Red Dead Redemption, though, where the DLC at? Where's the DLC? Shadow of the Colossus, where's the DLC? Sleeping Dogs, where is the DLC? Looking for that. Soma, DLC. Everything else, DLC. There's no DLC in this. Holy crap. Okay, so we got The Last Hope Remastered. No way. No fucking way. Remaster. What is the difference between that and the original one? There's no way. That can't take that long. You can't. This gotta be a cut. There's gotta be a cut in that platinum. There's gotta be a cut in time in that platinum. Cause there's no way this you could get this. What was it? What was it called again? Is it? Damn, I can't remember the damn Star Ocean game. It's been a while since I actually remember the damn games. But well, I don't know, man. Let the people decide, even if they even comment on this. But okay, Tales of Bestura. Okay, so you got. This is a good collection of tales right here. This is something I like to see right here. Wow. That is really impressive right here. That is really, really impressive. Spends a lot of time on RPGs. This is a guy where, it's so weird. Recently, I've been looking at everyone who's been playing RPGs. Now I'm actually seeing people who fucking play RPGs. Thank you. Like, damn, dude. Now it's time for me to start playing the damn RPGs. I don't know when's that gonna be, but Tekken's. What you got? Six and Tag Tournament 2. Okay. Skyrim is great, but no DLC. Last of Us. Why? You fucked yourself over, man. It's not good. Legend of Heroes, great. Playroom is great. Witcher 3, okay. DLC though. Some of these other games I don't know. Okay, Tolkien, yeah. Uncharted, oh man, come on, man. Yeah, at least get Uncharted 4 DLC. Like, holy crap. But it's good you got the Uncharted done. Vanquish, okay. Watch Dogs. Oh, okay. You do Wipeout HD DLC, okay. Alright, you want to do that DLC, but that in Borderlands, but nothing else. Alright. I don't understand that, but okay. You got the World of Final Fantasy. It's good. Yakuza 4, no DLC. YS. What are these called? That's great, you got them. That's good. And then Yakuza, no DLC. I don't know what, but okay. First trophy is, oh god, that's the first game you played. I feel sorry for you. If you want an awesome RPG experience, it's definitely not the first game you want to play. But it's great, you got 13 done anyway, so it's good. Your first platinum Skyrim, so that's good. Now, I can tell you're taking baby steps, and especially with this list. But I think you need to take some huge steps completing the DLCs. The only way for you to get the true ending, if you actually get the DLCs done. It's a possible chance you could have a 4.0 GPA if you get the DLCs done. And also your completion rate. Okay, I guess that's it. So yeah, final results. So like I said, if the completion rate was 3% higher, your score would have been great. There's nothing really unattainable other than the Naughty Dog DLC games, but you got to make sure you pay attention to that. I know you're taking your time on completing your games, but if you did majority of the DLC, you could have gotten a better score. You do have more platinums than me, so that is great. And you do have a lot of ultra rares, but if you're done with the DLC on some of them, your score would have been very, very good. Very impressive that you put a lot of genres, especially some of the unusual games. You do need to play more PSN games if you want to have a very good score, but you are killing it on Vita, so that is very fantastic. And with 600 trophies within the light and darkness, you will get a nice number of 6.7 out of 10. And I guess I'll see you on the next review. Okay then. Bye.